gonna share with you my favorite travel adventure. The story about how a bunch of strangers drove motorbikes for 4 days around the Ha Giang loop, became friends, and make memories that's gonna last for a lifetime.
I'm going to this Ha Giang loop, which is supposed to be, most of the people I talk to, it's one of the best things they ever done in their life, so I have really high expectations for this loop. It's supposed to be one of the most impressive landscapes anywhere. So yeah, I'm doing that, so getting there is not easy, of course. I could get a bus, but it wasn't cheap because locals don't travel there, so it's only a tourist bus, and tourist bus like 355,000, which is like 15 euros, which is just a bit too much. So I'll try to get there for free or for as little money as possible. I'll get there eventually. I picked up a car hitchhiking and they took me to their house because they wanted to show me this amazing sculpture. So they do this by hand. I don't know how much work is in this, but I imagine a lot. And it is incredibly detailed. Like there's little sculptures everywhere. So their tail. Very cool stuff. They don't speak absolutely no English, so I couldn't get the information how long it took to build this. But surely a lot. 38 degrees in the shade. Feel painful, let me tell you that. But that's what we do to save money. And this road is completely abandoned, so it's gonna be difficult to get a ride, but we get one. 2 hours later, still no ride because there's nobody here. And it's so freaking hot. Oh yeah. But it would be very cool to get there before night, because then I'll never get a ride. So yeah, after 2 hours of no luck, now is the time, I can feel it. So after 2.5 hours of waiting at one spot, I realized I was probably at a really bad spot. So now I'm going a bit forward and I'm completely empty streets, unless those motorcycles, a bit forward, and then see what happens, because now it's getting dark and it's also still super hot. I don't know, here just doesn't get stop getting hot even when the sun is down. But yeah, I need to get there. And if you look in front of me, it's just long empty road of nothingness. I don't know, nobody here. I don't know why. As long as I keep the spirits up, it's good. I don't know why, today I feel super optimistic because I've been doing this from 6:30 in the morning. And now it's like 6 in the evening. But usually I would be really, no, I'm tired. But usually I'd be really like pissed and devastated, or no, it's not the right word, just not be in a good mood, but somehow now I am, which is great. As long as I can keep the spirit up, my chances are good. So this super friendly man just came walking next to me, I suppose for emotional support. Yeah. And we're walking in the middle of this huge road. I'm not sure we're supposed to do that.
Oh,
because
my God.
The trucks are coming.
Okay.
Let's go that way. Okay. Goodbye, have a good day. Yeah, it's just a good little emotional support. Well, I totally forgot I was hitchhiking now. I could stop that. No, not like you would stop. And I could show you just the Ha Giang loop and there, but as you know, the inspirational quote, it's not just about the destination, it's about the journey. So I'm showing you how I'm getting to Ha Giang, because it's a journey on its own. If I would just take a bus, it would be expensive and boring. Now it's much more exciting, maybe not so pleasant and comfortable, but that's okay, we seek discomfort. These people are really, really nice. I guess, yeah, they don't really have just many foreigners. Even this dog is super excited. And so everybody would be really friendly. So I'm walking in like 10 seconds. I walk past two kids. And yeah, they're like patiently awaiting me to walk past them so they can greet me, I suppose. Yeah, they're... Hello. And they're like, oh. Yeah, so much fun. Oh, she loves me. She showed me she loves me. The kid back there. Yeah, people are friendly. Vietnamese people are very, very friendly.
So I finally made it. Now it's 15 minutes to 10 p.m. So from 6:30 in the morning till now, it was a long, long journey. That was one of the longest, toughest hitchhiking days I've ever done. But I've made it here. I also broke one of the very fundamental rules about hitchhiking. I would say that is don't hitchhike at night. I wouldn't recommend it to anyone, especially not alone. But I had to, because I was in the middle of nowhere and it was night already and I wasn't at the place I was supposed to be. But luckily then, like a very sweet tiny lady approached me, and she spoke English, which was perfect. People here don't speak English at all. And he was like very confident and everything, and asked me where am I going, and I said here and here, and I explained hitchhiking, because she asked, do you want the bus or something? No, I explained hitchhiking means you stop rides for free. And she was like, okay, that's perfect, because I have a car and we're going there, just we need to eat dinner first and you can join us. And then I joined them for dinner, they paid for everything, that they drove me there, we have a lovely conversation, everything. It's just really, really sweet. So, lucky, lucky. But I'm always somehow, even though it looked bad because it was night already and I wasn't nearly at my place, but somehow, at the end, everything works out, every time. That's the beauty about traveling. Here in the Vietnam, the people are probably the smallest I've ever seen. Men are not really. Men are pretty tall, I would even say, for Asian. But women, ladies are so small. Like the smallest girl I know from back home would be like the standard size here. They're like 1 meter... 50 centimeters is like a regular female size here. But yeah, I made it here, so it worked out like always. So now I'm going, this is gonna be one of the most rewarding showers after super sweaty, stinky, and now good shower and sleep and bed, it's gonna be perfect. So we just finished day one of driving. Yeah, this was pretty extraordinary. Amazing views and all the group is really, really cool. Back at the guest house. I think we're still going to some waterfall or something today to swim. We're getting a car. Yeah, the kids are everywhere here, and they would like, when you drive and they would hold their hand and then we up, bam, and then we'll give them a handshake, like a, what is this called? Whatever it's called. So yeah, really, really cool stuff. And just driving among these hills is just wow. Just wow, wow, wow. Look around everywhere. I mean, the landscapes here are really, really, really nice. And everything we had today, this kind of misty day, kind of rainy a bit. So we're all a bit wet, but that's okay because it was all in this super cool mist.
and like the forest upstairs, like totally in the clouds, and sometimes you even completely white, and you can just see motorbikes disappearing in the whiteness. It was like we're leaving the mortal world and entering the spiritual realm. It's like complete whiteness around us. Very, very cool. Yeah, it's about 7 of us in the group or something like this. Yeah, already we're kind of connecting very well. This and it's only day one, so I'm doing 4 days. I booked in my hostel, Lotus Hostel, so it's $140 for 4 days, which is a lot of money for Vietnam, but I mean for the experience, it's worth it, right? I wanted to do actually by myself, just rent a scooter and go by myself, but I've been told that you need this international driver's license to drive in Vietnam, which I don't have, and if you can't find, you pay way too much money, so it's not worth it. So I went with a group and the tour guides, everybody knows everybody here, and they make sure you don't pay it, so that's the whole thing. So that's why I'm with the group, but it's worth it because, I don't know, solo it would be good, but it's better to share it with somebody. So yeah, for day one, pretty amazing, and it will only get better. It's now 15 minutes to 8. It was a very long night yesterday with way too much drinking and karaoke. It was fun, but I'm not sure how we're supposed to do this. We have 3 more days. Yeah, and we have to drive ourselves to the mountain. It's a very dangerous road. And I think people are gonna be pretty hangover now. Okay, let's just hope as long as everybody keeps safe, it's okay. It was fun. This is day 2 of Ha Giang Loop. We're currently having some bike problems, that's what we're stopping. So one of our guide actually has some bike problems and they'll fix it. Yesterday actually me and two other people got lost because the rest of the group drove like that way and nobody told us, so we just went forward and we were up in the mountains, and as long as the road was not visible anymore, then we figured out they probably went somewhere different. We went back. But yeah, just a bunch of fun. Yesterday we had this fun night and today we're riding again this beautiful amazing scenery. The road is shut. There's some construction going on, that's why we cannot go forward. Probably about 200 people stuck here. Even on the other side. So probably maybe 400 people.
That night we had another big family dinner and drinking karaoke night.
We stopped to eat some breakfast at a local market. There's only 3 of us now and our guide, because the other went back to town and we go to China. But I thought I might share the thing that happened to me yesterday. So when this got locked, like you cannot put the key inside anymore. I didn't know that, nobody told me. The trick is you have to put the other side of the key in and like open it and then you can put the key inside. If you don't know that, if it happens to you that it locks somehow, so this is gonna help you a lot. Because I couldn't start it and then somebody had to come. Yeah, nobody told me that, but now you know. If you do the Ha Giang loop and the scooters lock, you do this.
I know. We're looking absolutely ridiculous,
But it's raining quite heavily and we have to go on a motorbike, so that's okay. Do what we have to do. This is the kind of roads we're driving on. And over there, it's a Chinese village. This is the first time I see China in my life. So we just arrived at the very tip of Vietnam. And all you see behind me, back mountains, China. So this is the second time I see China in my life. The first time was 10 minutes ago. And this is the second time. Amazing, amazing stuff. This trip has really been phenomenal. I think we can climb this one too, the tower. So maybe I'll do that. I hear some people inside, but I don't see the entrance. Ah, here it is. China. One day I'll visit China. Hopefully when they stop eating shark fin soup and rhino horn and they stop requiring visa, then I'll visit.
So
we're actually live on multiple TikTok streams, I believe. Like everybody here is filming a live TikTok. Just a very happy top of the mountain.
Hello.
We just got invited to some very special ceremony of saluting the flag. So it was a bunch of soldiers in these old Soviet uniforms and big guns, big old guns. I couldn't film it because it was, they say it's forbidden and I don't wanna mess with communist rules. But it was like super surreal, so everybody was like saluting. I was just like standing straight and respectfully. I wasn't saluting or anything because I didn't know what they were saying. But they had their own it was the national anthem, and yeah, a bunch of these soldiers and high officials were standing there and saluting the flag. So we got invited to that very special ceremony, which was a very, very unique experience for sure. I've never had this one before, and I don't think I ever will be, especially when communism is dying. So yeah, this was like once in a lifetime. And life here is actually still very, very traditional, even especially here in the mountains. So we still see like farmers everywhere who work on their rice terraces and corn plantations, and they have this, they drive sometimes with live pigs on the back of their motorcycle, not in a cage or something, but like strapped live big pigs squealing among the, and chickens, live chicken, holding them like this and driving. Very, very traditional, just things that you can see nowhere else in the world. This Ha Giang, so cool, so cool. Like everything here is amazing and unique. So basically what we're doing today, we're just getting closer and closer to China. So now we're literally at the border, Chinese border. Probably, yeah, it's electrocuted, it's a metal fence. Metal wire, really, pretty heavily secured. So they're just warning us to leave through the microphone. So we just stopped now because there's a police control back there. And yeah, basically we don't have these international driver's licenses. We're waiting here, and our guide went up ahead to see what's going on, and I believe he's gonna bring some drivers who's gonna drive us through the checkpoint, so we don't have to have these licenses, something like this, but we will sort it out, right? We'll sort it out. adventure is coming to an end. We're just playing a music that somehow perfectly captures what I'm feeling right now. But yeah, this has been like one of the best adventures of this entire 7 month trip. Yeah, this song, if you can hear it, it captures what I'm feeling right now. It's kind of a end of an amazing adventure, but okay, it's gone. But definitely I made some memories for the rest of my life.
I expected it to be about the views, but it turned out to be so much more than that. It was about laughter, friendship, making memories, about toasting with happy water in Vietnamese, singing, dancing together, and little kids giving you high fives from your motorbike. While the views were incredible, it was the people who made this trip so special. I'm thankful I got to experience all that with the group I had, Johnny, Max, Sam, Johanna, Christopher, Homel, Ocean, and our fantastic guide Nam, with whom I made memories I'll cherish forever.